Hey guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. My name is Julia, and today I am going to be changing my septum for the first time, and I'm super excited.
And I have the tippy toe so you can see what I'm doing. I don't know if it's a little too dark in here. I have my ring light that I made. There's a whole bunch of tutorials online if you want to know how to make your own ring light. I will put down below the links that I watched to create mine. And anyways, as I was saying, sorry if it's a little dark in here. I could turn my bathroom light on, but it makes everything super yellow. So I figured it looks better like this. So that's what we're gonna roll with. And I pulled out all of my septum jewelry today. Don't worry, I didn't go on this crazy like rampage after I got my nose pierced and bought all the body jewelry I could find for it. I actually had my septum pierced before, but it was pierced wrong. And I had that pierced for like 5 months, so I bought jewelry for it and then I took it out because it just wouldn't work out. It wasn't working at all, so I pulled out all my body jewelry for my septum piercing, and I've got some. I'm sorry if you can hear the background noise. My mom is in the kitchen, and I just feel awkward of like her being able to hear me. So I played music on the Google Home, and so yeah. This is what I keep to store all my septum jewelry in it. I have a whole bunch. I'm not gonna be doing a like try on of my jewelry. Maybe a different video. Just because this is going to be the first time I'm changing it, and I don't want to do too much trauma to it, you know what I mean? It's been 4 weeks since I've gotten it pierced, but since it's going to be the first time that it's getting changed, I don't want to just keep shoving things in it and get it irritated if it's not where it needs to be. Does that make sense? I hope I'm making sense. Anyways, I did end up ordering some body jewelry off of Body Art Forms. And I bought this little tiny, I've got two actually, one's a captive bead and one's just a regular horseshoe, and it was a half inch, and it's cute, it's a little perfect, right? I have another one, but I can't fit in my nose, like it's a perfect length, but it's not wide enough. So if you guys know of any company that sells a wide half inch horseshoe that is a 16 gauge, let me know, because, girl, look at this. Let me find it. Give me 1 second. Okay, so it's so tiny, and it would be perfect. Well, I mean, obviously this isn't how you put it in, but I'm just like showing you an example. If it was flipped down or whatever, but I know it's not. Anyway, so it would go like right there. So it would hang down just a smidge. Let me get closer. But the thing is, if I wanted to flip it up, the balls would be so close that I wouldn't be able to flip it in my nose, because I could barely get it to go up right here. Does that make sense? So I need one that's wider, because the one that's really small and tied together isn't gonna be great. And so I bought this one hoping that it wouldn't be, because it looked like it'd be a wider set. And it actually is like the same exact, oh, I almost dropped that in the sink. The same exact, like, how do I explain it? It's not wider like I thought it would be. So it looks like it's the same size. Can't get the balls up in my nose. Like, it just won't work. And plus, I can't even get the balls off to begin with. They tightened it so tight that I can't take them off. So let's get to the juicy stuff. Well, actually, just to let you know, I also ordered a septum clicker, which, if you want to see me wearing this, stay tuned in a different video, because I'll try that out whenever it's healed to a better state. Now what I'm doing, is gonna clean my septum piercing, wash my hands. If you want to know how I do that, you can watch the video that I'm going to link in my description box of my, I think it was like my 2 week update or my 1 week update. I don't know, but it's in the description box below. And also, I'll leave them link to the videos of me getting my septum pierced 4 times, so that'll be fun. Anyways, I'm just gonna pull my hair back and get started. So this is my septum flipped down. A little too big for my face. I mean, it doesn't, I don't know. Disclaimer, if you have it flipped up in your nose all the time, like I have for the past 4 weeks, because I just thought it would be better for it to heal in one place instead of being constantly flipped up and back, you know, because that will tear the tissue and make it a lot longer for it to heal. So I had it flipped up. And I also work, now I don't know if my work would be like, oh, take that out, you know, I haven't asked them. But just to be safe, I kept it flipped up, and so you get boogies, so you're gonna have to clean those too.
I actually don't even know if I'll be able to get the balls off of this. So.
Okay, so ideally I would like to put a hoop in my nose, but a lot of people that have these can't get them out after they put them in. And that kind of freaks me out a little bit, so I'm gonna lay off on that because, yeah. And the one that I'm gonna be putting in my nose, which I don't even know if it has a matching ball. Can I pull this up in my nose off? Yeah. Okay, so this is the septum that I'm... Septum. This is the jewelry that I'm going to be changing it to. It's almost the same size. It looks like it might be the same size. If it isn't, I'm going to be so upset. Because this is, no, it's a little smaller. It's like a size smaller, thank God. Or I would have been so upset because there would be no point changing it, you know? Okay, so I'm just going to clean this jewelry and then, yeah.
All I do is take the jewelry, get some Dial Gold soap, antibacterial. Don't get the one that has, that looks just like this, but is scented with like vanilla or something. I don't know what it is. Make sure you get the antibacterial one. So anyways, I'm just gonna put this on my horseshoe. And then I'm gonna rub it between my fingers and then get water and rinse it. Don't drop it down the drain. I wouldn't jinx myself. Just wash it and then go ahead and dry it on. So I'm gonna make sure my hands are nice and dry before I even try to take this out because I don't want any slipping. I might have to go back and get it taken out. I think I got it. Cool. That didn't take as long as I thought it would. Oh my god, now I'm a little nervous, I'm not gonna lie. So I'm just gonna wet the end of this just to lubricate it. Because I don't have any petroleum jelly on me right now. Okay, I'm gonna get the jewelry wet that's in my nose, just so it slides out a little easier. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. Okay. Let me get really close to my nose so you see what I'm doing. Oh my god, I'm nervous because they had a hard time putting the jewelry in when they were piercing my nose, so. I got nervous the first time too. Okay, it's out. Can you see the hole? Wow. Oh, it looks so much cuter. No, I'm just gonna try to put the ball back on. Hold on, I'm gonna pull out my, because I don't want this ball down the drain. Oh, I wish I would've put this the other way. This is gonna be. Oh, that was actually way, way easy. Wow. Wow. Oh, it's so cute. I hate that it falls down though, like that. And then, let's see if I can pull it back up. You have to make like a really ugly face to do it, like. I've worn this one before. There we go. And it's up. Oh, that's cute. That's a lot better. And then flipping it down. Oh my god. Oh, I love it. I really wish I could open the other one. Yeah, honestly, I want to know what the smaller one looks like in my nose. Because I feel like the one size smaller would be so. Like this size. It's just so thick that I don't even think I can go through that part of my nose. But it would be freaking adorable. That was me changing my septum piercing for the first time. I hate that it's laying down instead of hanging. Like, I wish it was just like hanging like this. If I can get it straight. I wish it was just hanging instead of like oh my god. Anyways. Well, there you go. Actually, I like the horseshoe look, but I feel like a ring wouldn't fall back like this. Should I put, no, we're not putting a ring in. Calm down, Julia. Okay, maybe next time I'll put a ring in it, but here is what this looks like for now. I'm gonna give you guys a close-up. If I can, focus on my nose. Oh, the light catches it so nice. That, honestly, didn't even take like actually changing it didn't even take like a minute. And I'm so happy. I think it's the cutest thing ever. I love it. Look at that. And then here's the original that was in my nose. Or like I was like, I don't even know if it's a different size. One like obviously smaller. Ooh, okay, I want to see something. So this is the jewelry that I got pierced with the first time ever, like over a year ago. It's this one. And then here is what I got pierced with just recently. It's like slightly smaller, like just slightly. But yeah, that's crazy. This was in my freaking nose. It was so big that I couldn't flip it up. This obnoxious freaking ring. Can we just take a minute? Like, it's like this bigger than my nostril. Okay, I'm sorry. Anyways, as I was saying, that was me changing my septum piercing for the first time. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up just to let me know you like it. And if you want me to keep doing videos that involve like jewelry or piercings, I'm not a professional piercer, but if you like this kind of content, let me know so I know to keep making it. And that's all for this video. So like I said, don't forget to like, and also don't forget to subscribe. And yeah, I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you guys so much. Bye.